Welcome back to the channel, guys. We're doing another boat wrap video. So for those of you who've been following the channel a little while, know that we have a raft. We had it for a number of years. It's a Stealthcraft Hooligan XL, and I'm sad to say, but the raft is gone. I'm not sure if the guy I sold it to watches this video, but I hope you're enjoying it. Really hated to get rid of it, but we kind of upgraded here, as you can see behind me. But since I've got my guide's license, I wanted a little bit more room in the boat, a little bit of a better rowing boat, and I just needed more room, really, to take a couple anglers and a bunch of gear. So that's what we got here. We upgraded to a drift boat. So I bought this for basically the same price we sold the raft for. It's a older drift boat. It's about 20 years old. Actually, it is. It's 20 years old. It's a 2004, but the person who had it before me kept it very, very clean. It doesn't look like it was used all that much. It looks pretty much brand new for the most part. So I'll show you guys what it is real quick. I did get to take one trip in it last year at the end of the year. Caught some nice fish. It was a great day on the water. The thing is awesome. Rows great. Ton of room. Let me get this thing uncovered and I'll show you guys what we're going to do to it and what it looks like. A 2004 Clackercraft low profile, 16 foot. In beautiful condition. The bottom is really pretty much new. The inside looks pretty much immaculate because I cleaned it and I put this flooring in here. This is spaghetti mat like we had in the raft. I just put that all on at the end of the fall here so we can get in with wading boots with cleats. And it won't tear up the fiberglass because this is a full glass boat. I did a little bit of foam work here on the sides, over on the other side, just to kind of dress it up a little bit. And put some new rope on it. Did a couple other little things here and there, but this is it. But today's video, we're doing a wrap on this. You guys have seen me wrap the trolling boat before and probably a couple other things. So we're gonna do that to this. This color scheme here is an old color scheme, which it doesn't look bad. It's not beat up at all. It's actually really clean. I just want to change it to kind of make it my own, give it a little bit of my touch to it. And I think it'll make it look a little bit newer. Well, you can see I got a lot of cleanup left to do after that. Those stickers been on there a while. All right, so we got all the stickers off. I'm gonna rub it down with some alcohol, get all the residue, cleaning product residue, grease, grime, everything off from here. And then we'll start laying out our knifeless tape that's gonna cut our wrap for us. All right, so the next step is to use this 3M knifeless tape here. I'll link it down in the description below. This stuff is awesome if you're putting wraps on anything. It basically cuts your wrap for you. So you can put it all on as one piece and then you pull this apart and there's a almost like a braided fishing line in there and it cuts your wrap. We'll show you how it works. We did it on the other boat. It worked really, really well. So I'm gonna try to follow at least this bottom line. I'm gonna go just outside of that bottom line the whole way up to the front of the boat, put this tape, so that'll be our bottom cut. And I'm gonna run a new line kind of up here, make this graphic a little bit higher all the way up through. So see how it goes. Pretty good. Laying down pinstripes.
So you can see we got this green line on there all the way down. We gotta do this upper part, which is gonna be kind of a pain.
So I drew a pencil line on here where about I want the top of my wrap to be. Go up in here and cut that off. Straight line there. Boom. Just like that. Alright, so that was a bit tedious, but we got it. Got it all done. All the tape is on. I'll show you guys real quick. Both sides are done. Green lines of tape, obviously. So now, I'm gonna fill in this whole part here. Pinches up. We're gonna cover up to here. Make this strip a little bit wider. And it narrows up to the top. I'm leaving this kind of back here a little bit so we can do this side first. And I'll pull the tape over and do the other side. So, should work out pretty good. I don't have a lot of room with the material that I got. This is a 16-foot boat, probably more like 16 and a half, 17 by the time you go around the bend here. So I ordered a 10-foot roll of wrap material, and it's 59 inches wide. So I'm gonna cut probably two strips that are 18, 19 inches wide to do the back part. And then that'll bring us 10 feet about right where this oarlock is. And then the other two strips will cut like 10 or 11 inches wide. And that should get us the rest of the way up the boat. So there'll be a seam right there. I'm gonna try to make that as least amount obvious as I can, but it's a camo pattern, so it shouldn't stand out too bad. So let's go check out what I got for a wrap, go cut it, and get this thing on the boat. So we got the wrap here. As you guys can see, you're probably gonna wonder where I got it from. I got it online from Metro Restyling. I'm not affiliated with them at all. Paid full price for this, so it wasn't cheap, but they're one of the better places, it seems, to get wrap material from. Online now, and you can see what we're using here. Get this all out. I guess this stuff is made by Relv, R-E-L-V. It's called their Moab color, and this is the X3, which means it's blown up like three times. The normal one is a smaller pattern than this, but I kind of wanted this bigger pattern to kind of stand out more, and I wanted a camo color for a couple of reasons. I picked this because it had the same color as the boat in there, so it's gonna be kind of like a stealthy looking color. It's gonna kind of blend in with the boat, not be too bright and flashy. And the thing with this is if I ever get a nick in it or a, you know, a puncture in this wrap and it shows through, you won't really see it because it's a camo, you know, random pattern, and the underside of the boat is this color. There is some blue in there, obviously, so if that shows through, shouldn't be that big of a deal. So, gonna roll this out, just see what we got here. Yeah, that's gonna be pretty cool. Dude, that's gonna look so sick. You guys can't see it, but you'll see it when we put it on. So you basically leave an air pocket in there. So you tack the top, pull the bottom tight, and you pull it all the way up so it's nice and tight.
Right.
And then you take your squeegee,
you start going up.
You start in the middle and go down. And then when you're done, you detach the top and then work up. That's gonna look sick.
Yeah, it is.
If it works. I hope it works. We got it sitting on there. As you can see,
get it tacked to the gunnel and tacked to the bottom. Tack it to the top, pull it down tight, leave an air gap in there. Start in the middle, work it down, take the top off, work it up, and hopefully you got a completed wrap. We'll see. I don't know. This stuff's pretty,
not as bad as the other stuff.
You know, I can't remember if that was a 3M product that we used last time, if it was like Avery. Once we get to here, it'll be good, but.
Keep doing what you're doing with that, and I think it'll be good. Yeah, that really softens it up. I think it is melting the glue a little bit.
Yeah, it's doing something. Boom, baby. Take that off. So I didn't really explain how we did this front piece. We did it differently than the back because we had less material. We didn't have enough material to stick the top of it to the gunnel there like we did on the back. We just did a little bit at a time. We started at one end. Josh peeled the paper back for me and I just used a squeegee and applied it on. And it went on really smooth, had no wrinkles, no issues. It was pretty quick to get that front piece on. That's exactly what we did on the other side. We also tried it on the back on the next side and it didn't really work as good because it was too big of a piece. So if you're doing this on a bigger boat and you're using a bigger piece of vinyl, I definitely recommend trying to hook the top of it to the gunnel, pulling down tight and hook the bottom of the wrap to the bottom of the boat and then just work from the center like we did on the back of the boat here. Yeah.
Way different.
So I grill in a reptile ice fishing.
This stuff feels so light, like it would just snap, but we didn't get exactly perfect, but pretty dang good.
Pretty good.
Yep.
Cool. Would have been so sick to do the whole boat like that, but that would have been pretty damn hard. Imagine we had a heck of a time just doing that piece.
Yeah, that would have been really hard.
That looks sick.
It does look good.
Is it down?
Is it down?
All right, so one of the last things I gotta do is I'm gonna take this 3M edge sealer here and basically just paint on where it's gonna mostly contact the water underneath here, and just kind of do a really light covering over the seam that goes all the way up the bottom here, just to kind of help that stay down. They recommend doing that on boats that's gonna be in contact with the water. The rest of this should be fine. So we'll just do a little bit down there, get the Clackacraft sticker back on there, and we should be good. Just using a little craft paint brush, and of course I picked my favorite color here. All right, so the final step. I got the Clackacraft logos, new logos. These are what they put on their new drift boat. We got the 16-foot low profile. I called them up and had them send me over some new logos so people know we're rowing a Clacka. And I'm going to pop these on real quick, and then we'll be done. I'll pull this thing out and give you guys a better look at it out in the daylight. Should look real nice with this camo. The black should be cool. Sick. That looks awesome. It's awesome. That makes it really, really kind of stand out. That black pops really nice on there. Still kind of stealthy looking, so I love it. Let's go take this thing outside, get the big camera out, and show you guys what this thing looks like. There it is. Try to get a better shot of it here. Came out really good. Really good. Put a keel guard on the front here just to protect that nose piece. It was getting kind of beat up, but the wrap is all done. It came out really well. You can see that back. The Clackacraft logo on there looks really good. Love it. So you guys can see there is one seam that really kind of stands out right here. But really, from a distance, you can't even tell. And on the other side, the seam came out really well. You can't really tell because the seam is on the darker section, and it kind of almost matched right up. All right, well, that's that, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Hopefully, if you're gonna do this to your drift boat or just regular fishing boat, that this video is a little bit helpful. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments below. Let me know what you think of this transformation. And thank you guys for watching. We're gonna get out on the water in this boat pretty soon, do some fishing, do a little filming. So stay tuned, subscribe if you haven't already. We'll catch you guys in the next video.
Yep. Fish on, baby.
Is it a bass? No, it's a salmon.
Oh, there we go. Got him.
Oh, came off. Get it.